This next topic explores the question of how to analyze a scientific paper. I've put together this document to help you dissect the papers that you may come across, and in particular, I would like you to evaluate the papers from the Sports Analytics Journal. So, in very generic terms, the structure of scientific papers is provided here with the information on typical titles, abstracts, and keywords. And by the way, this information will be important for you when you're working on your final projects for this class. So there's typically a well-stated introduction with a research question or hypothesis, and we will explore example hypotheses a little bit later. The methodology must be clear, some discussion about the results, and then potentially limitations and conclusions. All papers have a reference section, which highlights the relevant papers that have been used, cited, and how this paper builds upon those previous ones. That's important to know too. It should also be stated that Wikipedia is not a valid reference. It's a good resource to start exploring a topic, but it's not peer reviewed and it's not a scientific publication. So please don't cite Wikipedia as a primary reference. So, in order to summarize what a paper may look like, I put together the example table. And what I would like you to do is to select a paper from the Journal of Sports Analytics and complete the information in this table. So, in the first row, provide the citation. I am going to show you how this particular paper from 2016 about field goal probabilities, how that paper was decomposed. The keywords, I will show you where to find those, but it's always important to know what the authors suggest are the relevant topics that should be known up front. Then there's a research question somewhere in the paper, and that needs to be clearly stated, and your job is to find it. So the research question for the paper that I will be providing as an example is, can field goal success among NFL kickers be better estimated using this particular statistical method called the shrinkage estimation approach? The findings should also be made very clear. There should be no suspense here. The findings should be explicit up front and provided at the beginning so that the reader knows what to expect later. So what these researchers found is that the distance of the field goal attempt, which I will explain a little bit later what that means, and the location where the game is played are the two most important factors that influence whether a field goal will go in or not, or in their terms, the probability of a successful field goal. The data used to do the analysis is also important to note. In this case, 111 NFL kickers over the time period of 1998 to 2014, making 17,104 attempts, playing in 32 stadiums. Okay, and their source of data is a website called profootballreference.com, which is available for you to do the same analysis. And that's actually one of the important aspects of a scientific study is that the data are made available and other people can replicate their results if they had access to the data, which in this case, it's publicly available. The methodology is a little trickier to find, but essentially what these researchers use are regression models, and they used the R statistical software package, which is the same one we are using in this class. And most papers do have a list of limitations. This one did list a couple. The most important one is that their results did not account for kicks where it was somebody else's fault, other than the kicker. For instance, if the person holding the ball drops it or mishandles it, it affects the outcome of the kick, but their results don't actually know whether it was a kicker's fault or the holder's fault. Okay, so your job is to select a paper from the Journal of Sports Analytics and complete this table, all the information in this table for that paper. So, let me show you how to access a paper in that journal. Journalofsportsanalytics.com. You'll see the general topics that they publish, the folks that are involved from an advisory standpoint are on the left column, and then the editorial board is on the right column. These are the people who actually review the papers. You'll see that there are across multiple sports and multiple industries. So you might recognize a few names on the left, Mark Cuban, the owner of the Dallas Mavericks. Daryl Morey is the general manager of the Houston Rockets. A lot of really big names on this list. So what you do is you scroll down to the last link here that says View the Online Archive. And what that does is opens a second website, which is the publisher's website, iOS Press. And the link here that says Contents, you click on that in order to access the actual papers. Okay, so one of the things that you should note here is that all the issues, volumes 1, 2, 3, and then I guess now they have volume 4 available, are accessible here by expanding the menu options here, the trees. So what happens in academic journals is a volume corresponds to a given calendar year. And issues usually correspond to either the quarter of the year or half the year, or sometimes if the journal is very popular, they will have monthly publications. So it looks here that because there are two issues per volume, two issues per year, this journal is published every 6 months. You'll see that the papers themselves are in various topics. This first paper is about European football leagues. This one is about professional sports leagues in general. This next one is about professional basketball, the NBA. This one is Gaelic Athletic Association in Ireland, championship football. This next one is UEFA Champions League. This one is about the NFL, and we're actually going to examine this paper in a little bit more detail. And this next one is about NCAA football. This one is about baseball, the pitch effects data, NCAA basketball, and finally, cricket. So you'll see a lot of very variety and the options for different topics. All you need to do to access the papers is click on the link that says Get PDF. And this little icon, which is the orange lock that looks unlocked, means that it's open access. In other words, you don't have to pay to read that paper. And so that's the case for almost any of these papers, which is really a nice feature for us because it's freely accessible. Now, I've selected already a paper that I explained to you before on this study of NFL field goal success probabilities. But what I've done with this PDF document is I've actually highlighted the relevant aspects of the paper. For instance, this part of the sentence gives me an idea of what they studied, who they studied. Because remember, when exploring a scientific question, you need to identify the population, NFL kickers, and the answer has to have some variability to it. So in this case, they're studying field goal success probabilities, which varies between 0 and 100%. What I also found from this paper is they list what it is that they found up front. So they talk about the aim of this paper is to do this. Okay. And they look at weather, psychological pressure, not necessarily that, but to demonstrate that this methodology, shrinking regression-based estimators, are a good predictor of the probability of making a field goal. Now, again, the nice thing is you don't have to understand all the mathematics that go into the paper to be able to dissect the relevant aspects. So, for instance, they found that the single most important factor in predicting field goal success is the distance of the attempt. Okay, that's great. And how do they do it? Well, they used the R statistical software package. Okay, and the distance of the field goal attempt was obtained from this website called professionalprofootballreference.com. Okay, as it says here, profootballreference.com from the years 98 to 2014, 17,104 attempts across 111 different kickers. And the rest of the paper goes into some pretty sophisticated math, which you don't need to understand, but you need to identify, well, what are the relevant aspects here? Okay, so they looked at some way to estimate the variance of the field goal probabilities. Okay, and they borrowed the method from some researchers who used it to predict batting averages in Major League Baseball. Okay, that's important to know too. I'm still scrolling down here, and I wanted to point out towards the end, again, I don't have to understand all the numbers, but I am looking for keywords like limitation. The limitation of the study has to do with failed attempts that are not the fault of the kicker, perhaps partially the fault of the kicker. Okay, some more math, some more data. Here is a list of references. That's important to note too, because the authors point out the most important studies that they are building on, and they're putting their research study in the context of what other people have done in the past. So again, going back to my outline, you'll see that in just a short amount of time, without having to read the entire paper, I can identify the important elements. What is it that they're doing? How do they answer the question? Using what data? Using what methodology? So your challenge then is to do the same. You don't have to provide the highlighted PDF document. All you need to provide is this table filled out. And hopefully that will give you some ideas in terms of how scientific studies are done and the types of data that are used and the methodology that is employed.